dahon sa budbud. Nabibudbud, no? Okay. Budbud. Mark 7. Then pray for Pastor Ken and Ma'am Ruth. They're invited to go to China, but their visa has to be approved tomorrow. You know, approve ang visa. Kay, gi-invite man siya ng speaker dito sa atong mission sa China. And folks, listen carefully. What an opportunity that the Lord will take care of the visa. And please pray for Pastor Kent and Ma'am Ruth as they plan to go to China. Lord willing, in October, they may go beyond to India. And Pastor Kent is doing his while he is still young. Kini mga old carabaos, ayaw na lang tagplang plano-plano. Hello? Dire lang ta Cebu, kaon taglaswa. Ala. Gracious ladies, soul save 67. Wow, gracious ladies. Bak-bak! Magpasalamat ta sa atong gracious ladies. Karon they are praying for the missions offering, missions fund, because they want to give it the next month mission conference. And by the way, on the today is first Sunday. On the third, let me see now. On the second Sunday, next Sunday evening, we are going to raise now for our mission conference. Bugas, unsa pa? Baboy. Kanding, elepante, unya, kanang pork, sa pa?
Beef.
Sa pa?
Chicken.
Rice. Who's that? Rice. Okay, so, now here it is. That one? 67, and in Kaya, soul winning, 84 got saved. Yes.
Bak-bak!
Basta ka nang ma-save, malipay gyud-tagyud sa mga na-save. Magpasalamat nga doon tayo mga young people nga nag-win og souls sa Ginoo. Doon na tayo mga gracious ladies. Kinakatang mga gracious ladies, di lang nilaba. Mangabig ni Kalag, amen? Yeah, mga saba ni Bana kung alang-alang, oy. Oh, tara. O, nag-smile ang mga married ladies. Nag-smile, lipay sila, oy. Tinood mag-isa na. And then, in touch. 31 attended, followed up 55, drug 763, souls won, 89. O, na. 89. Kamong mga married men, apilunta mo aning in touch. Kay mo man yung grupo. Kaya dato sa Boy Scout. Mag-apilta sa Boy Scout. O, kung lalaki. Kung babae. Itong gobernador sa Cotabato, yun sa mga kaigsunan, niyani ko diri arong mag-sulti ninyo. Pero sa di pa kumusulti, atong bahinon ang mga Boy Scouts. Ang mga Boy Scout nga lalaki diri. Ang mga Boy Scout ng babae as pikas. Ang Boy Scout ng babae. Ingo ni Tiki Aba. Ingo siya, giinan siya Tikyo. Tix, puting gwapuhan ng atong padre. Oy, ng atong pare. Ingo si Tikyo, tinood na. Tinood na, guwapo kayo na siya. Atong pangutanon, kung anong guwapo siya. O kung, nansa. Pagkatapos, pangutan niya, Padre, kagwapo ni mo, Padre, oy. Nganong Padre nga, nagpare ka nga guwapo mong kakaayo? Ingon siya, ang, di man kunin ako haong, Madre. Kung di mo makatawa niya, doon ako mo'y sakit. Ingon si Tikyo, gusto na, tinuod yun na, di ka makuha. Okay? Welcome, Stephanie Marzon. Stephanie, stand, Stephanie. There, Stephanie. Pakpak yun, pakpak! Pakpak! Okay? Then we have Angel May Bacolado Estrella. Where from Bacolod City? Where is Angel May? Angel May? Huh? No, it's Angel May. Bacolod City, kitay? Bacolod City? Bacolod City, kitika? Oh, grabe. Ning mataga Bacolod. Okay. Abraham, you have a friend from California? Abraham Quillis from California, USA. Abraham, please stand. Give him a big hand. This morning, we had a gentleman from Albany, Oregon. He's not here now, but Abraham, you're welcome today, and we thank you for coming. Thank you very much. And we need to just pray that God will bless all of our Sunday school teachers, that they will have a time to visit. If you are a Sunday school teacher, kinahanglan magbisita mo sa inyong mga pupils. Amen. Oh. And I look at the record and visit three. Di amo na, three sa buong semana. Ako gani, makabisit ko na po without really going out. Just the people I met in the in the eating place or anywhere, I invite them. And so we need to just do that maybe. And I hope that you'll be able to visit your pupils and students. Kurt and Arlie, they are visiting the parents of Babius. We have never done this before. So we are happy that you have the opportunity. So among mga parents, sa academy, if you have not yet been visited, one of these days, they will come to you and visit you, okay? I hope you will prepare some ice cream. And if you do that, tell me that they are going to visit with an ice cream. And I think I can go alone. Marzon. Okay. We'll have the choir, huh? Choir.
Sides are here, and it's hard. As the choir goes down, we'll sing one song. Just sit down and we'll sing one verse of this song, Brother June. And then after which we have a report from our voice ministry. And let us be blessed by this report by Brother Ruben. Just sing one song with one verse.
Christ Eternity is a song.
One verse sing. It may be at morn when the day is awaking, when sunlight through darkness and shadow is breaking, that Jesus will come in the fullness of glory to receive from the world his own. How long, every shout the glad song, Christ returneth, hallelujah, hallelujah, amen, hallelujah, amen.
Okay, we're going to have a 1 minute video presentation, but before that, I would like to invite all the members of Bible Baptist Church to join Voice Ministry if you haven't been into a ministry, because especially this semester, we're going to encourage every members of volunteers of Voice to go through some discipleship, and then we will go to the area to see the results of the ministry. You will be encouraged, you will be taught how to visit and how to win souls, and to, you know, encourage the community to really listen to us, especially the preaching of the Bible, okay? So if you are have this passion already, as the Word of God has been preached to you, you are encouraged, come join us. We will have this training in this program, in this ministry. Please, June.
Time is running. In regular days, we can get so busy with work, studies, or business. We can get to the point where everything seems to be normal. However, will you enjoy yourself in your daily duties, issues are growing? Drug addiction, teenage pregnancy, rebellion, these are only some of the many things going on in our society. But let me tell you, we can do something about this. Voice Ministry is here to educate the young generation from different schools about the right values they needed to learn in order to walk on the right path. If you can give at least 1 hour class for every week, you are good to go. No matter who you are or what you do, you can make a difference with the time that you can give. Be a Voice volunteer.
Amen. Amen. So once again, I'd like to echo what Brother Ruben has invited each and every member to be involved in. This is a ministry, one of the ministries of our church here in Bible Baptist, and give at least an hour to be able to spread biblical values to our schools here in Metro Cebu. This morning, we also had our meeting over there in Mandaue, and we also reminded our volunteers of the same ministry, and we praise God that this ministry is opening up. Ang kulang lang yun na tumakigsunan volunteers. Maragi kulang. The harvest is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Let's all stand up, please, as we prepare for our offering. Let's sing one song, Brother Rafi. The second verse, Brother June, of that same song, Christ Returneth. And then on the last verse, verse number 4, 2, and 4. Let's sing.
It may be at midnight, it may be at twilight, it may be perchance that the blackness of midnight will burst into light in the blaze of his glory when Jesus receives his own. Oh Lord Jesus, how long, how long, every shout the glad song, Christ returneth, hallelujah, hallelujah, amen, hallelujah. ushers, please come, last verse now. Oh, joy, oh, delight, will we go without dying? No sickness, no sadness, no dread, and no crying. Caught up through the clouds with our Lord into glory, with Jesus receives his own. Oh, Lord Jesus, how long? Christ returneth, hallelujah, hallelujah, amen, hallelujah, amen.
Just quickly on the voice ministry. May Soonan, there are many schools in Cebu nga open. Open yun sila. Ang uban nga yung Tagalog ni Ingon nga naman nga, Sir Ruben, dili ka mo ani sa amo sa kwan sa lahog. Ingon siya nga, gusto namong mo na diha, pero wa may volunteers. Puting daghan. May kasunan, if you only know the burdens that we have. Kana lang Abiliana, nalugob na to? Wala pa gani. Sa Patira, Tihiro, day school, night school. Tanawa na. Unya, mga isunan, I tell you know, one of these days, you will know exactly what God means. The harvest truly is plenteous. But what? The laborers are few. Laborers. We ought to pray for this. Amen? Now, you make a living by what you get. Is that right? But you make a life by what you get. If you're a Christian, you ought not to only be concerned about living for yourself. Christianity is give, give, give. If you are a Christian and you do not give, 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 you are not a Christian. The proof of Christianity is your concern for other people. If you're not concerned for other people, I don't know what kind of Christian you are. Really. I am not putting you down. I am not putting you down. Just like the will of God. The will of God is always connected to the work of God. You say, well, I would like to obey the will of God. Really? I like to obey God's will. Yeah, namin yung Katoliko. Mayroon gani kay katong Katoliko na luwas. Mauna yung mga saba ni Aaron. Magsoon. Kinimbulhaton sa Ginoo. Tanawa na. Salamat nga buhita. Buhi ba ka? O tungod kay buhi, gitagaan tag opportunity nga magselbi sa Ginoo. What a privilege to serve. Brother Mario is working in the Bureau of Customs. What a privilege to be in the Bureau of Customs. What a privilege to be in the Department of Education or anywhere in government. But my friend, it's a greater privilege to serve the Lord. Naagod siya God, diretso sa Ginoo. Ang imong boss, Ginoo. So my sonan, when you give tonight, please remember that you are not giving for yourself, you are giving for the sake of somebody else. Okay? Brother, Brother Linjo, Brad Palihug, Brad, come. Brother Linjo, his son Kevin will soon depart for California.
Talagon ikaw, Diyos, nga amahan Ginoo, Lord. Salamat Ginoo sa mga activity. Salamat Ginoo sa Voice Ministry. O ginman Ginoo Lord, nagpasalamat kami labi na sa In Touch Ministry. O ginman Ginoo Lord, sa paghatag na mo karon, panalangin ni kini, matag-usa ka na mo Ginoo nga maghatag nini. Lord, among gipasalamatan, among gisalig Lord, kini kanimo ang tanan, sa ngalan ni Jesus. Amen.
Amen. God bless you. You may be seated. Now here is a special number.
Jesus will call against our death.
surreal. Then I just can't help but feel how much closer His coming is today.
Continue to look up, amen, and set our eyes, fix our eyes on the eastern sky. Our Lord Jesus Christ may come at any moment. Well, today or tonight will be the last of the series that we have been hearing on prophecy, and I would like to leave us with this message on the book of Revelation. The book of Revelation is the book of prophecy, and tonight we're just going to do a overview of the book of Revelation. And of course, through many Sunday nights that we have been together, we have already talked about specifics of very major events, prophetic events that are going to happen when our Lord Jesus Christ will come. But to continue your study, personal study on prophecy, I encourage you to focus your reading on the book of Revelation. To help you in your reading, our message tonight will do that purpose. So stand with me, please, as we open to the book of Revelation, chapter number 1, and we will read the first three verses of our text for our text tonight. We will be going through the whole book very quickly. We are not going to read all the chapters, but we're just going to divide it according to how the book of Revelation is divided, so it will help you in your study on prophecy. Revelation, chapter 1, verses 1 to 3, together read. The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave unto him to show unto his servants things which must shortly come to pass. And he sent and signified it by his angel unto his servant John, who bare record of the word of God and of the testimony of Jesus Christ and of all things that he saw. Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at end. There are three things to be blessed. Number one, read. Number two, hear. And that's what we're doing tonight. And number three, keep. And that's the key to blessing. Amen? Let us pray. Father, I pray that through the Holy Spirit, as each and every one of us open our hearts unto you tonight, that you will teach us, help us, guide us, enlighten us, especially with regards to things that will surely come to pass, things that, Lord, you have already written in advance, history of the world that is written in advance. We thank you that you have preserved your word through your inspiration. We now have your very words that we have read this evening. I pray that you will help us as we continue our study on future events, that this will bring continuous encouragement as we live our life for you and, Lord, glorify you each and every day. We thank you for all our visitors that have joined us in our service tonight. If there is anyone among them that has not been born again, does not know for sure, when they die, they will be with you in heaven. May tonight be the night of their salvation. May they understand that being born again is not transferring to another religion or entering into a new one, but rather entering into a relationship with you through your only begotten Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, whom you sent to the world to pay for our sins. He died on the cross, was buried, and on the third day he rose again to prove to each and every one of us that he truly is the only Savior of our life. We glorify your name tonight. We ask and pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated. Very quickly, as a way of introduction to the study of the book of Revelation, we would like to go to the central person of the book of Revelation. If you study the book of Revelation, the central person of this book is none other than the Lord Jesus Christ. He is the hero of the Bible, not just in the book of Revelation. Jesus is the center of the Bible. From Genesis up to Revelation, everything is all about Jesus Christ. Many people want to study prophecy and the things to come, and instead of the one that is to come. And there's no problem with sometimes studying numbers and studying about events and news articles and in line with prophecy. But sometimes we miss out on the fact that the most important thing in prophecy is to always tie them up with the Lord Jesus Christ. The word revelation comes from the Greek word apokalypsis, which means to unmask or unveil. Maunang sa binisaya, ang revelation is called pinadayag, gipadayag, gipakita. Kung unsay natabunan, ug unsay gimask, unsay giveil, now it is unveiled. And so, picture, like when there is a new park that is to be opened in a place. Mostly parks are places where someone exhibits their own work, sculptures, artists, And once a park is open, whoever was commissioned to make that monument, that sculpture, it is also the time that they unveil their work. At the time that they have cordoned off that park, ilang gitago unsa ilang gihimo, from just a piece of stone, the sculptor, the artist starts to carve out something there in his mind, and then in the right time, it is unveiled to the people for people to see that what was once before hidden is now revealed. Much like the Word of God. If you look at the Lord Jesus Christ, what has been veiled in his life when he came to the world, born in a manger with the baho and stench of manure and urine and dirt and itchy grass, and he was born as a carpenter's son, as a human father, a peasant for a mother, and his glory, the glory of God, the Son, Jesus Christ, was veiled, gitabunan. But in the revelation, makita nato that unveiling is taking place. And so Jesus Christ, when he first came, he came to redeem, but on his second coming, he is coming to reign. He first came to be crucified, but he is returning to be coronated. At first, he was hung on a tree when he first came, but when he is going to come back, he is going to sit on a throne. When he comes back, he is going to reign supreme over all the earth. He came as servant, but when he comes back, he is going to come as sovereign. So the central person of the book of Revelation is none other than the Lord Jesus Christ. And we find the clear purpose of the book is for us to understand the mystery of
the events, but we will never understand the mystery of all these events that are to come unless magpailalom ta, magpa-under ta sa kaalam sa Ginoo. That is why there have been many so-called false prophets, false kaning mga mananagna. One of those very prominent that we always hear on documentaries, on television is Nostradamus. And may the other Eastern names, uban mga karon mga new prophets that have come out, even prophetess, that prophetess, mga babae nga mga prophetess, mugawa sila ug magpaila sila nga sila ang future or modern day prophets. But the clear purpose of the book here in verse number 1, the word here is servants, to show unto his servants and his angel unto his servant John. Unless nga magpa-servant ta sa Ginoo, dili gyud nato masabtan. Thank God that John was humble enough in his attitude to be able to submit himself to God so that God could reveal to him the things that we are going to know tonight. And so the clear purpose of the book is for us to understand the Word of God through our humility with the Holy Spirit of God. The comforting promise of the book is that we are going to be blessed. I believe, as I just noticed this, you know, as the series had been going on for quite a few Sundays now, I think more than a month now, bisan sa among attendance dito, sa atong attendance sa North, nagkadaghan ang mga tao nga mo-join, maminaw sa prophecy. They like to hear prophecy. And I get feedback that say, na-encourage ko, Pastor, na-bless ko, Pastor, kay na-encourage ko that Jesus is coming soon. It gives me hope. And that's the comforting promise of the book, that you and I are going to be blessed by reading and heeding, getting it in our heart, the book of Revelation. We learn that what the mystery is of history, and the world can never understand what is going on and what is going to happen, but God is moving everything to a purpose, and the purpose is found in the book of Revelation. And that purpose is specifically in chapter 11, verse 15, the last part, where the Bible says, the kingdoms of this world have become the kingdoms of our Lord and of His Christ, and He shall reign forever and ever. Amen? We sing that in our hallelujah chorus. And He shall reign forever and ever. Diba? Mo'ni ang basi sa versikulo, anak nga kanta. This war-torn, sin-soaked, like what the trio sang, devil-battered world, will see Jesus sitting on the throne to reign in power, in majesty, forever and forever. A little survey of the Bible, if you may, reveals that the first two chapters has no mention of the devil. And the last two chapters has no mention of the devil either. This is such a blessing. The reason why things are such a mess today, because the world is so out of place. The church, the bride of Christ, belongs to the groom, but the church is not yet with the groom. Jesus is King of Kings, and He belongs in the throne, but He is not yet sitting on the throne. The devil is the criminal, and he belongs in his prison, but yet he is not there yet. That is why the world is so out of place. So ayog kaguol when things happen in the world the way it is, because wala pa man ma-align ang tanan nga purposes sa Ginoo niining maong kalibutana. And so James chapter 5 verse number 8 admonishes us to be patient, establish your hearts, for the coming of the Lord draweth nigh. And so that is the, what you call, comforting promise of the book of Revelation. And then certain prophecy of the book of Revelation is found in verse number 3, the last part, for the time is at hand. Now remember, gisuwat ni ang Revelation, gigamit si John the Beloved. And when he wrote this book of Revelation, it was written over 2,000 years ago. But when God revealed it to him, he told John, the time is at hand. It may not be immediate, ang second coming of the Lord, but ever since that time, it has always been imminent. It has always been at any time. Even tonight can be the night where Jesus can come. Amen. We are in the last days. Some people say, are we? When Jesus went up to heaven, the last days began. That's why in all the New Testament, you find the prophecies of his second coming. Just a quick survey, 1 Corinthians 10:11. Now all these things happen unto them for examples, and they are written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the world are come. Philippians 4:5, let your moderation be known unto all men, the Lord is at hand. James 5:8, be patient, establish your heart, for the coming of the Lord draweth nigh. 1 Peter 4:7, but the end of all things is at hand. Be ye therefore sober, and watch unto prayer. 1 John 2:18, little children, it is the last time. And as ye have heard that Antichrist shall come, even now are there many Antichrists. Wa pa ang pinaka-Antichrist, pero daghan na karon ang anti ni Kristo. Whereby we know it is the last time. The Bible describes in the book of 1 John who the Antichrist is. The spirit of the Antichrist is one that does not believe that Jesus is the Son of God. So if you find out any teaching in TV, in the radio, you read any book that does not acknowledge the deity of our Lord Jesus Christ, mga kaigsunan, that religion, that teaching is Antichrist. Jesus' coming is very near. Now, how are we to understand the book of Revelation? And this will be our message tonight. Just three things to be able to understand the book of Revelation as you encourage yourself in reading the book of Revelation, to put your mind in place as you read the book of Revelation. It's found in verse number 19 of our first chapter. Okay? The Bible says to John, God says to John, write the things which thou hast seen. That's the first part. Write the things which are. That's the second part. And write the things which shall be hereafter. So that's the third part. Tulura ka divisions sa book of Revelations. The things which thou hast seen, the things which are, and the things that are to come. So atong i-divide ang libro sa Revelation into three parts tonight. Okay? So first of all, this is now our main body of our message tonight, understanding the blessed book of Revelation, the things that were, or what John saw. In the book of Revelation chapter 1, John saw the majesty of earth's sovereign, the Lord Jesus Christ. He saw a vision of Jesus Christ. He saw Jesus as the glorified, the conquering, and the resurrected Christ. In Revelation, Jesus is not portrayed as the Savior anymore, but he is portrayed as the judge of the world. His countenance, the Bible says in verses 12, and I turned to see the voice that spake with me, and being turned, I saw seven golden candlesticks. In the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the foot, and girt about with paps, about the paps with a golden girdle. His head and his hairs were white like wool. Nindot sa diay ning puti atong buhok. Amen. Pwede sa diay kung ganahan mo magpaputi og buhok. His hair, the hair of our Lord Jesus Christ, was white as wool. This was what John saw. And white as snow. His eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burned, they burned in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters. He had in his right hand seven stars. Out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword, and his countenance was as the sun shineth in his strength. And when I saw him, John said, I fell at his feet as dead. This was the same John kaning nagsuwat sa Revelation nga nihigda sa bosom of Jesus Christ nga namaray, where Jesus even described to him as the one that is close to me. Kay si John, paraygo ni nga tao, namarayag siya sa atong Ginoong Hesus Kristo during the time when he was here. But the time that when John saw him again and the Lord Jesus Christ revealed unto him, not his Savior-like manner, but now his sovereign manner, John was shocked and to the point, nakuyapan si John. He fell down because of his majesty and his glory and his power. You know what? I think most of us have experienced, we have been a long time in this world, I think most of us have experienced this na, sometimes as we go along through life, naatay masugatan nga tao na the first glance pa lang, mutahor na kaniya. He did not say anything. He did not introduce his name. You don't even know who he is. But just at the sight of that person, mutahor na ka. You know, you are just like, oh, yes, sir. Sumaya to, sir. You don't even know him. It's just his face. This is what John actually felt, even but more. A thousand times over, to the point nga, when he saw Jesus, bam, nakuyapan siya mga kaigsunan, he fell as dead because of the majesty of earth's sovereign. This is what John saw. He is the same John that led the bosom of Jesus Christ, saw this, the sovereign Christ unveiled his glory, his majesty. And that is why the Bible tells us that every knee shall bow of things in heaven, of things in earth, and of things under the earth. And that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Every tongue. Tanan nga naidila mga kaigsunan, musagit, Jesus is Lord. Every tongue. No exemption. That is, maunay dating sa Ginoo. His presence and his aura is so powerful that you cannot but help but bow the knee. What John saw, the things that were. That's the first part of the book of Revelation, chapter number 1. We go to the second part. As you are reading the book of Revelation, the Bible says, the things which are. Now this starts from chapter number 2 and chapter number 3, just two chapters. So, tulo ang division sa Revelation, the things which were, the things which are, and the things which are to come. So, we are now on the second part of Revelation, the things which are. Now, the things which are, if you find here in chapter 2 and chapter 3, is focused on the seven churches of Revelation. And this comprises the mission of earth's saints. Kita. Nga mga anak sa Diyos. Are you a born-again believer? Amen. Amen. Kay daghan mag-born again ron, but they are not believers of the Lord Jesus Christ. Born again sila, member sila o born-again church. But if you ask them, luwas ka, hinaot pa. Dawato na ko ang Ginoo. Inigdawat nila, luwas na ka, luwas na ko. Inigugma, ambot lang. Mawala-wala ang kaluwasan. Dili na tinuod nga born again. Ang tinuod nga born again, sumala sa Bible, is one that truly knows what it means to be born again. The Bible says, he that hath the Son hath life. If you have Jesus Christ in your life, dili na mawala. Men can philosophize. Like the book of John chapter 10, verse number 28, no man shall be able to pluck them out of the hand of God. Napag yun niingon, pwede yun ay kang makuha. Kaya niingon man, no man shall be able. So naag yun ay, pwede mawa. Giyon sa man, pastor, on sa man, Brad, on sa man pagkawa. Kaya walay maka-ibot ni mo, pero pwede sa kamuambak. Pwede kuno kamuambak. Wala ka-ibta, pero ikaw, kung gusto kamuambak, pwede kamuambak. Pero wa nagisulti. It's just a matter of philosophy. Human philosophy. The Bible says, foolishness. Foolish and unlearned questions avoid. Si Adan, naabay pusod? Wa man siya mataw. Wa man siya umbilical cord. Okay, wa man siya mataw. So si Adan, walay pusod? Wala man nagisulti sa Bible. Let's avoid those things. Amen? Maglalis, pinatiyanay. Kay si Adan, walay pusod. Ang usa na ay pusod. Onsa may nauna, ang itlog, ang manok. Paghimo sa Ginoo. Grabe ya. Foolish. But we have a mission. Our mission of earth, saints, and the mission is to go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. This is what we are doing as a church. This is what we are seeking to continue to do till Jesus Christ comes. Now, in the two chapters, okay, it talks about the seven literal churches, which also represent seven periods of the church age. Okay? So, pagsugod sa chapter 2, diri man nagsugod, o chapter 3, diri nagsugod ang church of our Lord Jesus Christ, sa Old Testament, Israel, sa New Testament, church, unya mga kaigsunan, usara ang tumong ni anang duha ka mga institution nga gitukod sa Ginoo so that they can be able to declare the true God, Jesus Christ. And so, these seven churches, makita nato diri by way of survey, you can find it in these two chapters, the Church of Ephesus, the Church of Smyrna, the Church of Pergamos, the Church of Thyatira, the Church of Sardis, the Church of Philadelphia, and the Church of Laodicea. Seven literal churches, assemblies that were there before but are not there anymore. They are there geographically, but they are not there as churches anymore. But nevertheless, they also prophetically represent seven periods of the church age. The church started during the earthly ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ. So let us divide this, these churches into our church age from AD 33 up to our present age. So the church, first church is the church in Ephesus. It started in AD 33 to AD 100, the first century church. The word Ephesus means vigilance. This was the time when the Word of God was completed. The Holy Spirit of God had been able to move in His holy men so that they will be able to write out the Word of God. They were very vigilant in writing the Word of God. It was also a time of establishing the doctrines of our Lord Jesus Christ by which we as a church need to live out in our daily lives. The church in Ephesus, it was the time of establishment. Secondly, the church in Smyrna. It was the time of persecution, AD 100 to 312 AD. Okay? The church of Smyrna. Smyrna means persecuted church. And this was the time under the Roman Caesars nga nagkagrabi ang persecution sa mga Christians. This was the time when you were known to be a Christian. If you remember the early church during this time, one of the apostles, James, was beheaded. This was the time also when Stephen, the deacon, was stoned. This was the time when many of the church leaders and church members, they went down to the catacombs, nagtago sila because of the great persecution of the church. And then many were hung on crosses. Many were tied to posts and then poured a wax, kanang wax sa kandila. And they were lit up, and they would be tied, and they would line up the streets of Rome, and they were lit up, literally lit up. And these Romans would say, "Oh, you claim to be the light of the world? Here you are. You are the light of the world." And they would light up the Christians to light the streets. They would be fed to lions, and then they were made entertainment. "Oh, what will be our entertainment today?" Wa sila TV, wa sila internet. Was sila mga amusement parks. So their amusement was the feeding of the, "Today we're going to have, we caught Christians today. Yay! Malingaw na sadta. Adto ta sa Coliseum because we have Christians. Ipakaon sa Leon." We were the world's amusement. Many, it was a bloody time for Christianity. The church in Smyrna meant persecution. The church, third church, the church of Pergamos. Pergamum. Pergamum means marriage. It was a day, an age in AD 312 to 590. It was now the marriage of the Roman pagan religion and the beliefs of Christianity. In 313 AD, Emperor Constantine declared himself to be Christian. And when he declared himself to be Christian, he merged the doctrines of paganism, the Roman paganistic beliefs, he merged it with the doctrine of the church and the doctrine of the Word of God. Iyang gi-merged makaigsunan, and out came forth the Roman Catholic Church, meaning Roman Universal Church. And that is why we have pagan rituals in a Christian setting, not really setting in a way na ay mga Christian names, na ay mga agid-agid kaayo mo nang kanang kanibitaw nga kaning rhetoric sa atong presidente karon napagan ba yata na kay naaman siya na mention nga gituhoan nato sa Biblia nga in actuality dili gyud na tinuod gyud nga gibarugan sa maong simbahan nga iyang gitirahan. They believe in so-called creation, but yet they espouse and they encourage evolution. Many priests are teaching evolution in their catechisms, and they question the doctrine or the belief and the teaching of the Bible teaching of creation. But this was a time of marriage. Mo nang kabantay mo nga sa Biblia wala man na magtudlo og imahin, pero ngano man nga daghan sa mga Catholic faithful maingon man sila nga nganong malainan man mo imahin nga si Saint Peter man na pareha ra man ta na man na sa Bible, Saint John man na, si Santa Maria na man na sa Bible, pareha ra man ta. And that it causes confusion. But God is not the author of confusion. It is the devil that is the author of confusion. And that is why we need to get back to the Bible. And one of the things that we can be able to help our community know what the Bible says is to be able to inculcate biblical values through our values ministries. To inculcate in the minds of our those that are in prison, our Reformers Unanimous Ministry. To be able to go out and win souls, much like what our In Touch and our married ladies and our young people are doing. To give out the Word of God, give out what the Bible says. This is what we need to do. This is the mission of the church. Because the devil has been confusing people. Karon ni intra na sad ang uban nga mga reliyon. And si Jesus og si devil, si Satan brothers. Nagyapon si Jesus. Unya si Jesus naa sa ilang libro, pero dili siya Dios, prophet siya, sama sa ilang propeta nga si Muhammad. Si Jesus naa sa ilang simbahan kay simbahan ni Kristo, pero dili gyud si Kristo ang ilang gipalabaw, si Manalo. And there is so much confusion. And that is the devil's tactic to get us away from the Word of God. And that is why the many religions are now Bible plus. But salamat mga kaigsunan, as born again believers and as Bible believers, we have always stood with what the Bible only says. And that is why you need to be thankful that we are here. For 61 years, we have held to this stand and held up. And we have always said to this community, we are the church of what the Bible says. Pergamum was an era of marriage, the union of church and state, the union of paganism, and the union of so-called Christianity. Gisagol nila para malibog ang mga tao. The church in Thyatira, another church, was a church that had a false prophetess. And it spanned the era of the Middle Ages, 590 AD to 1517 AD. This was also a time when nagkagrabi ang persecution. Labi na sa Europe. The Christians of Europe were highly persecuted. And that is why in the Church of Sardis, AD 1517 to AD 1750, there had been a revolt in the church, Roman Catholic Church. There had been a protest. That is why there is the Protestant movement. One of those Protestants that came out of the church upon reading the Word of God was Martin Luther. Niingon siya nga, abi nako nga ang kaluwasan bayaran dili diay. Because the Bible says here that only by faith the just shall live by faith. And he kept on reading that and reading that and reading that. And it came to his mind, and the Holy Spirit's conviction continued to penetrate his mind. And he said, no, it is not through indulgences, it is not through works, it is not through all this, but it is only through faith in Christ. And so he protested. And many other friars and monks and priests protested. And they were all killed and persecuted. The church in Thyatira. The church in Sardis, I mean. And so because of that, because of the great persecution in Europe, many of the brethren, the true Christians, fled Europe and crossed the Atlantic Ocean and landed in the new world called what we call now as the United States of America. They built a society that would usher in freedom in worshiping the true and the living God. Amen. That is in AD 1750 to 1925. This is what we call the church in Philadelphia. Philadelphia means brotherly love. We thank God that because of the freedom in America, they were able to establish churches. They were able to establish the Word of God in the hearts of the Christians. They were able to establish strong believers. And through that, many in America, many in Europe, went out into all the world to preach the gospel. Ug niabot ang gospel sa Pilipinas. Sa ato lang a missionary, Bobbius came 1953. About 1953. And mga kaigsunan, in the 1900s, this is where the church of Laodicea started. This is the seventh and the last church. We are in the last church. The era of the last church is upon us. Now, the word Laodicea means people's voice. It means lukewarmness. It means higher criticism. This is the age where my rights, ako, higit sa lahat, akong gusto, akong hunahuna, ako, grabe ron. And sadly, it has also penetrated the church. Sadly. That the churches now want the Bible to adjust to them, not us adjust to what the Bible says. It is the church of the Laodiceans. If you do a survey of the churches, the church in, pero pag abot sa Laodicea, the church of the Laodiceans. Nawa na ang Ginoo sa church. This is the church of the people. What we want to do, let's do it. Neither hot in serving the Lord, neither cold in serving the Lord. Naragisto nga. Simba karon, aw, tanaw lang na to kung ganahan ko. Wa man sad siya mo biya, wa sad siya mo init. Naara lang, okay lang. No? Nya, mo-appeal kas boys, mo-appeal kas Ario, mo-appeal kas sa young people, mo-appeal kas awana, mo-appeal kas married men, married lady. Aw, tanaw lang na to niyo. Mo-appeal kas sa missions conference, mutabang ka. Mutabang ka sa medical mission, mutabang ka sa atong evangelism. Ambot lang, tanaw lang ni. Mutabang ka sa Bible distribution, tract distribution. Tanaw lang na to ni. Balance akong life, pastor. Unsa may balance? Sa Lunes, na ako sa kalibutan. Sa Domingo, na ako sa Ginoo. Balance ba? This is kaya puro lang tas Ginoo niya, was kalibutan. Now, this is kalibutan. This is kaya puro tas kalibutan, wa tas Ginoo. Balance. Sayop nga filosofiya. But the church in Laodicea, we are in this church age. This is what John was told by the Holy Spirit of God, the things which are. Maoni ang present age. Naa si John diri sa AD 33 to 100. Naa siya sa Ephesus. Naa siya, natunong siya ani. This is your age, John. And there is going to be the Laodicean age, and it's going to be in the near future. Of course, he didn't know the exact dates, but he had to mention in his writing the six more churches. But he was in the age in the church of Ephesus. But there is one phrase that keeps coming back and forth in chapters 2 and chapters 3. Unsa man kaning verse nga kaning pulong, he that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. The Holy Spirit is speaking to us today. The question is, are we listening? He's speaking. He's speaking through His Word. He is speaking through testimonies of other Christians. He is speaking to what is going on in the world today. He is speaking to us. Are we listening? He writes to the seven churches. Seven is God's perfect number. It's God's perfect number. One is the number of unity. Two is the number of witness. Where two or three are gathered in my name, there is a witness. Kinahanglan kung naa kay isulti, naa kay witness to be able to establish something. When we go out soul winning and go out tract distribution, going out door to door and following up or visiting or whatever we do, we must go two by two. The Mormons got that right. But we got that right. Kay ngano man, Pastor, sobra, bisag dili two, three, usay four, usay five, daghan kita? Sobra pa? But at least two. Three is a symbol of triunity, the triunity. But we're not going to numbers, but I'm just saying that seven is God's perfect number. Seven churches here in the book of Revelation. And then we'll go to the last part of this message. If you're going to read the book of Revelation, things which John saw, the majesty of God, the Lord Jesus Christ, the things which are, kaning atong panahon karon, in chapters 2 and 3, and then here we have been talking for many Sunday nights, the things that shall be. Chapters 4 up to chapter 22. So inigmasa nimo sa chapter 4, wa pa ni mahitabo. Naapata sa chapter 2 and 3, or chapter 3 to be precise. We are in the church of Laodicea. But what we are waiting for, what we are now getting ready for, what we are looking up for, is chapter 4. If you go to chapter 4, verse number 1, the Bible says, "And this I looked, and behold, the door was opened in heaven, and the first voice which I heard was as it were a trumpet talking with me, which said, Come up!" Maunang atong gibarugan sa what the Bible says, nga ang rapture, this is talking about the rapture, come up! Is pre-tribulation. Naman sa Bible, oh? Come up, trumpet. Asa man na? 1 Thessalonians 4:16, review lang ni sa atong nakatuna na. "For the Lord Himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God." So, gipakita ni John diri sa Holy Spirit, the trumpet talking with me, and the trumpet said, ang trumpet ni sulti. Imbis ang trumpet, but the trumpet says, come up. Masig mo unay tingog, no? Kay ingon man diri, "For the Lord Himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God." Basig mo usad ni. Dili tingon sa trumpet, kung dili tingog sa Ginoo. Ang nasa trumpet, delete music nga what we are accustomed to. Or what the nation of Israel is accustomed to, kanang ilang trumpet of assembly. Probably, the horn. I'm just surmising, okay? Now don't be dogmatic about it. Delete na mag-away, ani. Ingon si pastor, kuon, sayop na, delete na doctrinalisa. Di na lang ta mag-away, anak. Tukion pag yun na, eh. Ayun na lang ta, anak. Magkatagay lang ta. Imagination ba? Amen? Lipay ta ba? Total pareha mo abot ng tas langit tanan. Amen? Musulti ang trumpet, muting, unay sound ng trumpet, doesn't really matter. Trumpet does not matter. Jesus matters. Mo nang balik ta. Mo ni kung pasabot. Ang sentro gani nato si Jesus, di ta mag-away. Pero sentroho na tong trumpet, sentroho na tong events, mag-away ta pre-millennium, post-millennium, pre-trib, mid-trib, ta mag-away, uy. Amen? Dito mag-away, oy. Pero ang gitudlo sa Bible, dire, pre-tribulation. Amen? Hindi lang gihapon na mag-away. Amen? So, morning, Moni ang chapter 4 to chapter 22, the things which shall be. And this is what we call the massive fright, kakuyaw of earth summary. Ang conclusion sa kalibutan nga atong gipuy-an karon. Dili ta ngayon makuyawan. We should not be afraid of this. But we are learning this why so that we can be able to have the passion and the zeal when we share the gospel to people. Because we know how dangerous it would be if they reject the Lord Jesus Christ. So here are seven branches, very quickly, seven branches of prophecy. I want to go fast here. Seven branches of prophecy that will sum up chapter 4 to chapter 22. So first of all, the rapture and the translation of the saints. Ato na ning natuki. Okay? Number two, the rise of the beast, the antichrist, and the deceptions of the devil. This is now the first half of the great tribulation. After the rapture, we now have the great tribulation. We studied this last week. Chapter 13, verses 1 to 3. When the saints are taking out the antichrist, the beast of the revelation, the devil incarnate, he is going to emulate and he is going to copy Jesus Christ as God incarnate. He will be the devil incarnate, the beast will come, and he is going to turn the world into a great concentration camp. He is going to deceive the whole world. Now, that is just a picture of what is written here, but that is not the Antichrist. He is going to be more handsome than that. That's an animal. That describes his nature. That does not describe his appearance. The Antichrist will be a beast in his character, but his countenance, oho, buutan kayo, murag di ka paak og langaw. Buutan kayo. Mo nagdaghan ang mailad, moingon siya peace, and there will be peace, false peace. He will say unity, and there will be unity. Tanan united, wanay mga protesta, wana ma-united ang bayot, ma-united ang straight, ma-united ang left, ma-united ang right, ma-united ang tanan. Ma-united, wanay away. Wow, mo na ni. It is going to be a time of great deception. And because they are going to be deceived, they are going to be under this great deceiver, the Antichrist, and they are going to mark themselves and identify themselves with this great person. I want to be identified with him. And he is going to give them a mark, and we know that mark. Both small, great, rich and poor, free and bond, a mark on the right hand and their forehead. The number is 666. You cannot buy nor sell, do commerce and trade without this number, this mark. At this time, men will be acting like machines. Karon ang mga makina karon, they are acting like people, like men. Artificial intelligence. But during the tribulation, it is going to be the other way around. Men are going to be acting like machines upon the control of the Antichrist. And then we go to the tribulation, the second half of, this is number three, the third division of biblical prophecy, the tribulation and the great judgment of the world. This is what the Bible calls the great day of God's wrath. When God is going to pour out his wrath, the scrolls, the vials, the four horsemen of the apocalypse, they're going to usher in the wrath of God. Diri makita sa tibuok kalibutan ang kalagot, ang kapungot sa Ginoo sa sala ug sa mga tawo nga nagpaulipon sa sala ug sa yawa. Chapter 6, verse number 12, and I beheld with, just a sample, ha? Sample lang ni, when he had opened the sixth seal, and lo, there was a great earthquake. The sun became black as sackcloth of hair. The moon became as blood. The stars of heaven fell unto the earth. Nangahulog mga kaigsunan ang mga bituon diri sa kalibutan. Even as a fig tree casting her untimely figs when she is shaken of a mighty wind. And the heaven departed as a scroll when it is rolled together, and every mountain and island were moved out of place. the Philippines will be moved in some other place. The coordinates anymore, the GPS will malibog na. Asa namang Pilipinas diri man to, nawagtang man, will be moved. Ang Bohol, muatos Mindanao. Ang Mindanao to as Luzon. Ang Visayas to as Palawan. Ang Palawan ni merge sa China. Ikuha din sa China. Nindot ni, nindot. Doolra. Kuha din sa China. Ang China, China lang gihapon. Grabe ning China. Bitaw. Pero niingon ang Bible, grabe ang earthquake, grabe ang natural calamities. When all these things happen, verse number 15, the kings of the earth, and great men, the rich men, the chief captains, the generals, and katong mga mighty men, and every bondman, free man, wala na itagdanay ani. Na ako'y kwarta diri, tabangi ko, I don't need your money. General ko, wakakailan ako, tabangi ko, ato ko dito, wap, to each his own. Everybody hiding and everybody scampering and under the dens and the rocks and the mountains. And when they were under the mountains and under the rocks, they would say, patya na lang mi, mga matay na lang mi, fall on us mountain, fall on us rocks, and hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne, because this is the great day of the wrath of God. But you know what? During that day as well, in Revelation chapter 9, verse number 6, notice this day. Por si kaso, nga maabot, maapil ka ani ba? Ha? Just in case. Ayaw pamarka? Number 2, ayaw na lang paghikog. Nga naman, Pastor, Revelation 9:6, tanawa. And in those days, men shall seek death. Makuyawan ka, gusto kang matay, oy. Di ka kaagwanta ba? Maratol ka? Ma-distress ka? Di ba? And shall not find death. They shall desire to die and death shall flee. May pamaghikog, ambak sila sa 101. Taas man ang 101. Wow! Ang iha pamatay, oy. Naunsa man eh. Di mamatay. Masig ka ning zombie apocalypse, mauna ni. Mauna ni. Gi-ana-ana lang ta ba? Mauna ni. Bang! Dako kayong buslot diri, wagi pong matay. Tinood! Mauna ni. May pamatay. Ah, hurot na ang dugo, luspan na kayo. Di nakakinalagluta mga kaigsunan. Puti na ka. Di gihapong ka mamatay. During this time, di nakaginanang pagluta. Iniglaslas ni mo, waan na. Kung naaka pa ani, ha? Ha? Kung naaka pa ani. Just in case, mo appeal ka ba? Isultian lang kasi may tabo ni mo. Ayaw na lang paghikog kay walay pulos imong paghikog, di ka mamatay. Paligis! Pang! Nahiwi imong nang mamatay. May pagdi na lang ka paligis kay di ka mamatay. Karon daganta sa kamatayon, ang gukod ang kamatayon, jogging ko. Di ka gukod ang kamatayon, kay jogging, exercise, vitamins, ana, si gukod. Pero karon in tribulation, ikaw, mangita kamatayon, dali, ang kamatayon, dragging sa dagan sa siya. Baliktad, tinood. This is the great day of God's wrath. Dato, pobre, ngilngig nga tao, bantugan nga tao, they're going to say, oh, I want to die because wala, di sila mamatay. Dive sila sa ilawom, sa ocean, higot sila og kanang bato, di sila malumos. Unsa naman eh, di mo kong mamatay. Nahurot na nila ang malatayon, di gyapon mamatay. Laliman ka ni ana. Musamot ilang kasakit, musamot ang ilang kalabad sa ulo, musamot ang ilang suffering. Manang kaning suicide, dili gid pil di gigani. Whether nag-tribulation or karon, pil di giga. As pastor always keeps repeating, suicide is a permanent solution to a temporary problem. That is the devil's idea. Those days is going to be a great day of God's wrath. And then the day of Armageddon, towards the end of the tribulation, the world, in chapter 16, verse 13, the world is going to meet the unclean spirits from the depths of hell that are going to whisper to the kings of the earth, to the people of the earth, let's gather together, ato ning awayon kaning Ginoo nga gusto ta mamatay, di ta matay. Gusto ta nga ma-okay niya, he is the one. Because the devil is trying, has always been against God, and let's go against God. And so the people of the world that will believe the Antichrist is going to go with him, and they're going to come to this great valley in Megiddo to have this great battle called the Battle of Armageddon. The armies of the world, according to Revelation 16, 13 to 16, and they're going to bring their armaments, they're going to bring their spears, their swords, their guns, their nuclear kaning mga weapons nila, but they're and they are thinking they're going to come together and fight against this common enemy, Jesus. Because the beast is going to control the world at this time. But in chapter 19, verse number 11, the Bible says, "And I saw John, saw the vision of things which are to come. I saw the heaven open, and behold, a white horse, and him that sat upon him was called Faithful and True. And in righteousness he doth judge and make war. His eyes," again, "were eyes of flaming fire." Dili ni ka ng puwa nga contact lens. Bani-bani, blue, green, kuyaw kayo. Di mo match sa color ba? Kung mag-contact lens, i-match sa inyong color, eh. Kana mga puti, mga blue, ngayon na sila, na. Mga aquamarine. Pero kung ikaw, brown, ayaw sa doy. I-match ba? Mas, hindi ka to. Masa maning... One time, a sales lady, nakakita ko siyang mata, itom tanan. Buhi ka, day? Buhi ko, sir. Ano, itom na imo. Di ba, dapat, naman ay duha kalingin sa sod? Itom tanan. Murag patay man eh. Kuya ka, itom tanan. Kuyawan ko. Buhi day siya. Contacts ni sir, contacts. Contacts na day eh. But this is real fire in the eyes of our Lord Jesus Christ. And on his head were many crowns. He had the name written that no man knew but he himself. He was clothed in the vesture dipped with blood. His name was called the Word of God. The armies which were in heaven followed him. This is us. Huh? Upon white horses. Kinalang kibawat ang sakay kabayo. Amen. Pastor, waman ka. Nasa gaysano ka ng kahoy bitaw. Kanalang, barato rana. Kana na lang. Amen. I remember sa una when I was growing up, mahuhog kong 25 centavos sa Foodarama, sakay ko, lingaw kay ko, ako mama, mag-grocery si mami dito niya, ako dito rin ko, suna sa 25, wana, sold na ko. Piso, wana, sold na ko. Mahuman na si mami yung grocery, wana. Kibaw ko mo, kabayo. Kung di ka kibaw magkabayo, mahulog ka. Wala na sa Bible. But at any rate, we are going to follow Jesus. Amen? Yeah. Woo. And then out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword. Pap! And he will smite the nations, not individuals, but nations that are fighting against him. He shall rule with a rod of iron. Makaigsunan, observers lang ta. When we ride together with our Lord, he is going to be ahead of us. You know, ayaw kay, ikaw, ayaw, relax lang. Lagot ko nimo, ayaw, relax lang. Let God take care of the war, amen? Ayan, nag-apil-apil, mahulog pa lang ka. Lagot ko nimo, nahulog na noon, nangaway pag yun. Let God take care of it. Sa iya lang sulti, ugdaw ang tanan. That's how powerful our God is. Wow. Oh. And I saw the beast, the kings of the earth, and their armies, verse number 19, gathered together to make war. But they were all defeated. Which brings us to the millennial reign of our Lord Jesus Christ. He's going to step on the earth, and that will be the beginning of his rule here on earth. And he is going to chapter 20, verse number 1. I saw an angel come down from heaven, having the key of the bottomless pit and a great chain on his hand. He laid hold on Satan the dragon, the devil, bound him 1,000 years. In the millennial reign of Jesus Christ, walay gubot. The picture of the lion and the lamb is a symbolic picture of peace. Walay away. Kanang away sa banag-asawa, away sa mga igsuon, away sa ginikanan ug anak, hungihong na sa kaaway, away mo. Gamay ra kag bahin. Siya dakog bahin, away. Kuha ang imo. Mga igsuon, di ta mag-away. Oy, sa kwarta, sa yuta, sa sinin, ay di ta mag-away, ana, oy. There is no value to relationships. Priceless ng relationships, oy. Mag-away ta sa kwarta, mag-away ta sa yuta. Ha? Huh? Sir, wakay problema kaya kung yuta, naraman sa akong kuko. Good. Okay ra. Mas maayo. Para way-away. Amen? Then we will have the final judgment of the sinners, those that have not accepted the Lord Jesus Christ. This is going to be a sad day. Very sad. We will have loved ones here, friends here. We will have neighbors here, office mates here, people who have rejected the Lord, no matter how much witness you have given to them, and if during the tribulation time they have not accepted the Lord, they're going to be in this great white throne judgment. And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life, Revelation 20, 14 and 15, was cast into the lake of fire. It's going to be a sad day. There will be tears. That is why in the Bible says God will wipe away all your tears. All our tears. Kung pwede lang, umudawat ta para sa atong higala, pwede unta, pero mga kaigsunan, dili gid pwede. But then the last part of prophecy will be the eternal state and destination of mankind. And this will be our time together with our Lord Jesus Christ. 21:5, and he that sat upon the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. The old is past, the hurts of the past, the memories of the past will be gone. The sorrows of the past will be gone." Sometimes, you know, we have forgiven, but there is sometimes the unforgetfulness that makes it hard. And sometimes we feel like we have not forgiven. We have, but kanig yung remembrance, mooni. But then God will make all things new. A new heaven and a new earth. God is going to come down and live with us. The new Jerusalem will come down on the earth, the new earth, and he's going to live with us forever and forever. Mo nang giingon diri sa last part, verse number 17 of 22 and verse number 20. And the Spirit and the bride say, "Come." Let him that heareth say, "Come." Let him that is athirst come. And whosoever will, let him take the water of life freely. Verse 20. He which testifieth these things saith, "Surely I come quickly." Amen. Even so come, Lord Jesus. Are we investing on eternity? Or are we investing just in this world? If you want to enjoy your investment in eternity, invest now for the work of the Lord. This is the time that God has given to us. Invest in people. Invest in the lives of people. Invest in programs that help people come to Christ. We have just launched our new school year in Bobbius Christian Academy. A week ago, our Bible Baptist College. We are investing in the lives of young people and people who are willing to be trained to be able to spread the gospel to the world. To be able to have students in Bobbius Christian Academy that will make an impact in the lives of their family, in their community, and the world. We praise the Lord for many of our graduates now that are preachers and missionaries and professionals that are spreading the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. But let me tell you, Jesus is coming soon. Amen. He is coming soon. Let us not kanabitaw magtiaw-tiaw ta sa atong kinabuhi isip Kristohanon. Kung naatay mga struggles sa atong life, kinahalan atong i-confess na sa Ginoon, say, Lord, please, I surrender my life to you. Please take away this struggle that is hounding me in my life. If there is sin, anger that is in your heart, surrender it to the Lord. If you need to grow more in the Lord, say, Lord, help me to grow more in you that I can be, until you come back, be of service to you. We need to prepare for the coming of Jesus Christ. The things which were, the things which are, and the things that is to come. Heavenly Father, thank you for the book of Revelation. Thank you for this blessed book that truly has given us inspiration and encouragement of the great day where we will be with you. Lord, as born-again believers, we are not worried about your wrath because we are not under your wrath. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. But Lord, we have a great responsibility to those that are still under your condemnation and wrath, that are still at enmity with you, to share to them how that they can be able to come to you and be reconciled back to you. Help us to be faithful reconcilers, witnesses, ambassadors, gospel sharers, evangelists, O Lord God. Thank you for your word. We are awaiting that great day when you will come. And Lord, help us to occupy till you come. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Well, heads bowed, eyes are closed. This is a revelation of what will happen to humanity from the beginning of time until the end. But my friend, listen carefully. If you are not saved, you will go to the great white throne judgment. Because of that, you are going to be thrown into the lake of fire. If you are not prepared, you need to prepare. The preparation is very simple. Repent of your sins. Accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. Then one day, if you are saved, you know the Lord Jesus Christ, you'll go down with the Lord during the second part of the tribulation period. You'll be riding in a horse, and you will see how the Lord will take care of the enemies at the Battle of Armageddon. You need to understand that this is being given to us today, so you will know exactly how your future will be. The only way to prepare for the future is today. And today is the accepted time to receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. You do not need any more explanation. You have decided, you can decide. The Holy Spirit is speaking to you because this is a very important part of our lives as a Christian. While your head is bowed, eyes are closed, the piano plays softly, and if you're not saved, you need to come. Come to Badis Bunga, Brother Walker. I want to be saved. I want to be prepared. Jesus Christ is preparing a place for us, but I wonder how prepared you are when the day comes. And if you're a Christian and you're backslidden, you need to come. We love you. We will pray for you. We'll stand with you. Open the Bible and tell you how you can be, you can come back to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunities we have as a church. And for those of us who do not know Jesus Christ, I pray that today will be this decision. Because we do not know when you will be coming back. Because when you come back, we have no more chance of ever getting saved. No more chance of accepting Jesus Christ, because the day, the time has ended. The opportunity is gone. It is now for us today, Lord, to remember that we are open, and the Bible says that we have the opportunity, the chance. Jesus Christ is waiting. His hands are outstretched to welcome those who would like to come and receive him. Believe that Jesus died and was buried and rose again. And Jesus Christ did that in order to pay for our sins. Lord, we thank you for your love for us, your patience, your mercy. And I know that you still have the patience today to welcome those who are really willing to come and receive Jesus Christ, the only Savior that can take us to heaven. In Jesus' name, heads bowed, eyes are closed. I would like just you to stand, go to the aisle, come to the front and say, I want to be saved. I want to be ready. I want to serve the Lord. Today, I want to come to the altar and I want to present myself to the Lord just to make Him know that I'm available to serve Him. Is there anybody like that? Come on. Just stand. Men, would I ask the men first? If you like to come, men first, stand and come to this altar. Thank God. What an opportunity. Thank God, what an opportunity. Yes. Mga lalaki, I want to serve the Lord. I will be available for Him to use in the kingdom, to win many souls to Jesus Christ. Ladies, if you like to come tonight, please stand to your feet. Go to the island, come. Tell the Lord your desire. Tell the Lord that you want to be used by the Lord in winning people and bring many souls to Christ. The opportunity to serve. Yes, God bless you. God bless you. Would you come? God bless you. Yes, amen. Amen. Thank you. Just come. Just come. The Holy Spirit is inviting you tonight because the Holy Spirit wants you to be ready for that great day of the Lord. The great day of the Lord is the time when God will intervene in the affairs of humanity. And His intervention is either a blessing or judgment. But today the opportunity is for you to decide. Because when the day of the Lord will come, you have no more opportunity to make a decision for yourself. Because the Lord has decided already that you will be thrown in the lake of fire. Anybody else? Yes, God bless you. Anybody else? Just stand and be right here. Be serious. Pastor, I would like to be serious in my service, in my soul winning, in my discipleship, in my Bible studies, in the work that I'm doing. I'll be serious in my Christianity. I'll be serious in reading the Bible. And in my prayer life, I will be serious because I know there are yet many that do not know Jesus Christ, their personal Savior. What a testimony of John. The things which he saw, the things which are, and the things which shall be hereafter, the things that will be. Anybody else? Those for baptism, you can come. You do not wait for the tribulation to obey the Lord's baptism. If you are saved, today you have to obey. What is the purpose? Not to be saved, but to align yourself and to express your loyalty to the Lord and to identify with His death, burial, and resurrection. Number three, you are going to follow the Lord's baptism because you want to become a part of the local New Testament church. Anybody else? Father, we are grateful for the opportunity to hear this message, and we thank you for the Bible. We thank you that from chapter 1 of the book of Matthew until the end of the book of Revelation, you have revealed to us the opportunities that we have to serve you and to be a blessing. Lord, we give you all the glory and the honor for all of these that are here at the altar, these men and ladies, and those in the pew that they need to come and identify themselves. Those who have not yet followed the Lord in baptism, help them to follow. And Lord, help us in our ministries, the Awana, the Voice Ministry, the Baja Ministry, the Blessed Ministry, the RU Ministry, and all the things, the Medical Mission Ministry. We need to just understand that these are opportunities for us to gather the people that needs to be won. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen.